Hello friends, and welcome to the tutorial on getting started with tuples. At the end of this tutorial, you will be able to understand of what tuples are, compare them with lists, know why they are needed and where to use them. Before beginning this tutorial, we would suggest you to complete the tutorial on getting started with lists. Let us start our IPython interpreter. Type IPython and hit enter. Let's get started by defining a tuple. A tuple is defined by enclosing parentheses around a sequence of items separated by commas. It is similar to defining a list except that parentheses are used instead of square brackets. So type t is equal to within brackets 1 comma 2.5 comma within double quotes hello comma minus 4 comma within double quotes world comma 1.24,5. The item is the tuple are indexed using numbers and can be accessed by using their position. For example, t, and within first you have to type t, then type t within square brackets 3. It prints minus 4, which is the fourth item of the tuple. Similarly, type t within square brackets 1 colon 5 colon 2 and hit enter. It prints the corresponding slice. This behavior is similar to the of list, but the difference can be seen when we try to change an element in the tuple. So type t within square brackets 2 is equal to in double quotes hello, h is capital. We can see that it raises an error saying tuple object does not support item assignment. Tuples are immutable and hence cannot be changed after creation. Then, what is the use of tuples? We shall understand that soon, but let us look at a sample problem of swapping values. Pause the video here and try out the following exercise and resume the video. Given a is equal to 5 and b is equal to 7, swap the values of A and B. Now switch to terminal for solution. Type A is equal to 5, B is equal to 7, then type A, then B. You can see the values. We now create a variable say temp and swap the values using this variable. So type temp, T-E-M-P is equal to A. Then A is equal to B and B is equal to temp. Then type A, then B. This is a traditional approach. So let us do it the Python way. So type A and B, then A comma B is equal to B comma A. Okay, and then type A, then B to see the output. We see that the values are swapped. This idiom works for different data types also. So let's try A is equal to 2.5, B is equal to within double quotes hello, where H is small letter, then A comma B is equal to B comma A, then A, then B. Moreover, this type of behavior is something that feels natural and you would expect to happen. This is possible because of the immutability of tuples. This process is called tuple packing and unpacking. So type 5 comma to see what is tuple packing type. What we see is a tuple with one element. So type 5 comma within double quotes hello, where h is small letter, comma 2.5. Now it is a tuple with three elements. So when we are actually typing two or more elements separated by comma, those elements are packed into a tuple. When you type A comma B is equal to B comma A, first the values of B and A are packed into a tuple on the right side and then unpacked into the variables A and B. Immutability of tuples ensure that the values are not changed during the packing and unpacking. So this brings us to the end of this tutorial. In this tutorial, we have learned to define tuples, understand the similarities of tuples with lists, like indexing and iterability. Third one, we know about the immutability of tuples. Then swap values the Python way. And finally, understand the concept of packing and unpacking tuples. Here are some self-assessment questions for you to solve. First one, define a tuple containing two values, the first being integer 4 and the second is a float 2.5. And the second question is, if A is equal to 5, then what is the type of A? The options are integer, float, tuple, string. And the final question, and the third one is, if A is equal to 2, 3, what does A in square bracket 0, comma A in square brackets 1 is equal to 3, 4 produce? And the answers. The first question, a tuple is defined by enclosing parentheses around a sequence of items separated by commas. Hence, we write our tuple as within brackets 4, 2.5. The second one, since the given data is 5 followed by a comma, it means that it is a tuple. And the final answer, the operation A in square bracket 0, comma A in square bracket 1 is equal to within brackets 3, 4 will result in an error because tuples are immutable. So we hope you have enjoyed this tutorial and found it useful.